thank you, Madison, for joining us today.
Absolutely.
On your Twitter account, you put down and tweeted, I should say, four things that should already exist in the year 2018, which me and my staff thought was hilarious. Wanted to ask you now, since you're in Ring of Honor, what four things should you look out for, or watch out for, since you're now part of the Women of Honor?
Which four things with me specifically?
Yes.
Well, I mean, I guess I can answer that just in one bullet point, is that, you know, and I know that Jay spoke to this earlier about we as performers to be as prepared as we can for every match. We do our homework. We watch matches of our opponent. We study our opponents the best way that we possibly can. And I know that. I've done it before. But for these girls in Women of Honor now who may think that they're going to get the upper hand on Madison Rayne by doing that, by watching, you know, they've got 10 years of footage that they can pull up on YouTube and try to watch and think that they know what I'm going to do. And I hate to keep going back to the same phrase of reinventing myself, but that's literally what I've been doing. I've been learning new wrestling moves. I've been learning new in-ring psychology. So the four things, I guess, that I'm going to bring to the table, I can all be encompassed in one phrase, and that's a brand new Madison Rayne.
Great. Great. Thank you. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
All right, Morgan Richards from Radio
Cardiff,
all the way over there. Go ahead, Morgan.
Hey, Madison, how are you doing?
I'm wonderful. How are you?
Not too bad, thanks. So, of course, you mentioned earlier that 2018 has been one of the really standout years for you, even though you've been 13 years in the business. What would you really put this down to now and being able to compete with so many various companies as you have in the last couple of months?
Mm-hmm. So I've spoken a bit about this. It was roughly a year and a half ago that I sat down on my couch in my living room with my husband and had a really tough conversation where we tried to decide if maybe my career was coming to a close and what that was going to look like, or if I was going to take any frustrations I had and any bit of second-guessing myself that I was doing, and I was going to flip that on its head, make it a positive, and totally change who I was and turn, make a drastic turn in my career path. And I think in moments like that where you're questioning what's next is where you really dig deep enough to find yourself and figure out what you want and what you're able to still provide to this business. And I am so glad that I was able to do that, that I got to that point mentally where I thought for a second that maybe it was time to look towards retirement, because I very quickly realized that I wanted to do the complete opposite. And I think that that has been probably the biggest contributing factor in my insanely successful 2018, because when I made that decision to change myself and to elevate my game, that's when opportunities started coming left and right. But, and you know, I'm not just saying this because of the position that I'm in now. I knew early on when I was being given all of these opportunities that I obviously was going to take them all and be grateful for all of them and do everything I could with them. But it's been the better part of a year that I've known, I think, in my heart that where I was going to end up was going to be Ring of Honor.
Amazing. Cheers, Madison.